CSRFs used to be a really popular back class, but then browser developers did something really smart and they introduced a cookie attribute called SameSite that was supposed to prevent these vulnerabilities. But did it really kill CSRFs? Can you still get good bounties for CSRFs in 2024? Well, there's only one way to find out, to do the case study, and so I did. In this video, I will tell you what techniques still work in 2024 and how you can still get good bounties for CSRFs. Enjoy! And the first label that I have in this category is very optimistic for the future of CSRFs, because in 38 reports, I decided that the SameSite cookie would not, SameSite lags to be more precise, would not help because the request with CSRF was using the get method. And there were a few different types of attacks here, different types of get requests. I broke this down in the other part of the case study that's in BBR Premium Archive. But for example, it was a report like this one in Facebook where the hunter would send a GET request that wouldn't directly make any modifications on the server, but it would cause the client-side JavaScript to immediately, without any user interaction, send the request to the server. And this request done by JavaScript would be a POST request, and it would have the proper CSRF token and everything, but the attacker would control the path of this request and potentially parameters as well. So the attacker would control everything, the client-side JavaScript would automatically append the CSRF token, and in this case, same site attribute with the lax setting, or with the strict to be honest as well, does not help you. And this report, it was submitted in 2022 when same site was already working. It was $18,750, so quite a good report. We see that Facebook, I think, has problems with these types of CSRFs, because take a look at how many Facebook reports we have here. That's 8 reports, a few of them in 5-digit bounties, so quite an important bug class. The next category that I found here was before same site defaulting to lags, because if we take a look at the reports, CSRF reports by year, same site attribute was introduced in Chrome back in 2016, but for 4 years it was pretty irrelevant because only Chrome supported it, and also developers had to actively implement this, which, you know, developers are not really eager to implement new defense mechanisms until they have to, and it makes a lot of sense from the business perspective. And in this period, you couldn't even properly recommend same site cookie as a CSRF prevention because it only worked in Chrome. So for 4 years it was quite irrelevant. Then in 2020 Chrome started defaulting to lax when the same site attribute was not present. And then Firefox followed up in 2021, and that's when the same site attribute started become relevant, and today it's quite a fundamental part of the client side security. For example, in this category we had maybe reports like this one. It's also in Facebook, and that's a pretty standard POST request where the cookie has to be attached for this request to work. And with same site lags, a cross site request like this just wouldn't have the cookies automatically appended. There is one catch to it. It's a 2-minute attack window, but more on this in the later chapter, because I have a separate category for that kind of report. Now we'll jump to the next category, or the next two categories that I have here, are where same site attribute was unmentioned, but it was already in this period where it was relevant. To be precise, 11 reports were when only Firefox would not default to lags, when Chrome would already default to lags, when SameSite was not present, but Firefox didn't. In this period, you could always write in the report that, you know, this CSRF would be mitigated by the SameSite attribute, but, you know, it still works in Firefox. And there was one report like this. It was in Atlassian. And, you know, let's not get into details of this particular bug, but the hunter did write that due to the same site behavior, it doesn't work in Chrome. It only works in Firefox. And props to this hunter. He got $3,600 for this report. And to authors of these 22 reports, which didn't mention the same site attribute, shame on you, to be honest. I think every single CSRF report after 2020 should mention the same site attribute, no matter if same site cookie will be appended, it won't be appended, why it won't be appended, doesn't matter which outcome it is, you should always address this in your report, because it just, first, it solves a lot of problems with the triage. I'm 100% confident that in at least a few of these reports, there was a case that the report only worked in Firefox, the hunter only used Firefox, but the triager used Chrome and it didn't work, so they would go back and forth with the report. I'm 100% sure there was a case like this. And if you address those things straight away, you will just get better bounties. You know, always when doing these case studies, I start with the highest paid reports and I go to the lowest paid reports. And I always, in every single case study, I see the same trend that the highest paid reports always, in general, mention every single aspect of a bug, every single prevention mechanism that could affect the bug, but maybe it can be bypassed in one way or another. And then the further I go, the more rare it is for hunters to mention it. Maybe they don't know about it. Maybe they just try to avoid the difficult conversation about the same site attribute. But definitely it shows that if you understand more aspects of web security, you will get bigger bounties. Then the next category, I have 6 reports where it was explicitly said that the same site cookie was none. 4 of these reports are in Google, and one of these I did cover on my channel. It's a CSRF by David Schutz, which I really liked. He kind of exploited the TV version of YouTube to leak private videos of the victim, and he got a CSRF like this. It's a great report. I will link the video and the report in the description. To be perfectly fair, this report could also go to the previous category, because this article does not mention the same site attribute at all. But I know that same site cookie was set to none because I just asked David before making the video. And I think because he mostly hacked on Google, and Google, at least back then, used same site none everywhere, he just didn't consider same site cookie as the relevant for this report. And while for me it was like, why does this work? But he sent me a screenshot where it was same site nuns, and that's why I know about this. Then we have two more categories with 1 report each, because the bug only works in Firefox. I already have shown you. The first case is something that maybe shouldn't be here, if I'm honest, but it's a report that I really like, and I wanted to have it in at least one of the case studies, and it wouldn't fit anywhere better than it fits to CSRFs. It's a bug by Johan Carlson, which I also covered on my channel. It's a client-side path traversal, and the way it works is that in one of the places, instead of a regular ID, you are injecting a dot dot slash character, which is typical for path traversals. But what happens here, it's on the client side, and then when the victim would press, in this case, this button to resolve or ignore an issue, I think, or an error, then the put request would be sent with a proper CSRF token. It would actually be a same side request, and because you would control the path of this request, and you also could inject URL query parameters, and Rails is known to treat these URL query parameters pretty much the same way as the put body or the post body. You would just control the path and attributes of the request, so you would have sort of a site-wide CSRF. The reason why I think it doesn't quite fit to the CSRF category is it ends up being a same-side request, and CSRF stands for cross-site request forgery, and this isn't really a cross-site request, but I think it somehow fits to the CSRF category. That's why I wanted it here. And one more reason for having it here is I think it is a back class with a lot of potential for the future, because a lot of applications these days do a lot of work with the client-side JavaScript. And I think bugs like this will only become more common. And in cases where you can't find regular CSRFs, you should be looking for client-side path traversals. So that's also a reason why I wanted to include this bug. If you didn't quite get it from my quick explanation now, the link to the full video and the link to the report are in the description. And the last thing I have, but the very important thing I have, is this $3,000 report in Yahoo. And the reason why I think it is very important is because the whole video about same-site cookie defaulting to Lux, I'm saying you that if there's no same-site attribute, the browser defaults as it would be same-site Lux. But Chrome only does it after 2 minutes from setting the cookie. And this is very, very important, because it means after setting the cookie, you have the 2 minute attack window where the cookie works as it worked before. In this case, the hunter, it is, I'm surprised, this is the only report where the hunter explicitly mentioned exploiting this 2 minute attack window. And the reason is, I mentioned it, is the 33 reports I showed you before, that I told you that maybe these reports would be mitigated by this mechanism and they wouldn't work today. This is the only sort of scenario where you could still exploit those CSRFs. And now the question you might have, 2 minutes after the login is not a lot of time, and you would be right, but when I'm saying 2 minutes after setting the cookie, it is not the same as 2 minutes after the login, because cookies are not only set after the login, you know, cookies are rotated all the time. And even if I'm logged into a website for days, for weeks maybe, probably my cookies are being changed a lot. And when you have a CSRF which does rely on this 2 minute attack window, you should also try to find scenarios where you can force the cookie to be refreshed. For example, if after opening the main page of the website, maybe cookies get refreshed. Maybe if a logged in victim opens a login panel, maybe then their cookies get rotated and they remain logged in. You should seek scenarios like this, because then you can just open this 2 minute attack window yourself. And in this context, 2 minutes is then a lot of time to carry out the CSRF. So I think the three most important takeaways for you from this whole video is, first, pay attention to GET requests if they in one way or another can cause some changes on the server. The second thing you should pay attention to is the 2 minute attack window in Chrome. I think it doesn't work like this in Firefox, and I don't know for how much longer it will work like this in Chrome. And the third thing is obviously pay attention to same-site non-cookies, because same-site can break some things, especially if you want functionality like embedding your YouTube videos on other websites. Same site breaks this functionality, so look for this. If you are interested in more specific types of these things, check out the full case study in BBR Premium Archive. And if you are not a member of BBR Premium yet, I recommend you this free video about IDOR case study. For now, thank you for watching and goodbye.